Dad pushed every year to get a plastic tree. But we never surrendered.
Plastic trees are fucking easier to maintain. There's probably also some stuff in here. Yeah. What was the kid running away from, and did his father see something? Some bagged trees.
How can they sell so many trees in such a small town?
That's a good question.
You coming, Sean?
Don't worry. I'll be around.
Hey, what's up?
Nothing. I'll tell you later. So, what do we do?
Hi. Everything all right?
All good. Quiet morning as usual.
It's not much, but she probably needs it more than me right now.
Hmm.
Too bad we can't come and see.
Hmm.
Maybe we'll get some leftover pies and eggnog, at least. Ugh. We only it's weird to have all this food products. Around after a month of a ravioli diet.
Hmm.
Hey. Hi.
Good morning, young man. It's nice to see a new face in this old town.
Thanks. It's a super cool market you got here.
Small towns are the best for Christmas. Who are you staying with?
Mm.
We're just passing through, so, at a motel.
Well, I saw you speaking with Charles, so I thought...
Huh. Yeah.
Oh, we're not related. My brother Daniel's friends with Chris.
Gotcha. I like his son. Funny little guy, despite everything. Anyway, welcome to Beaver Creek. If you need anything, just holler.
Hmm.
You won't find better deals in Beaver Creek.
Ah, I don't have enough money. Damn it. I totally would have bought something. Maybe I can ask Chris for just a... few extra dollars.
Hi, everybody. We're taking Christmas a year off to run away from cops. Daniel has got telekinesis now. Hope you're doing well. Claire and Steven definitely have a kink for Christmas. Bet they like these.
Each of our wreaths is unique. Special price if you buy two.
Hmm.
Is that a yo-yo? Daniel had one back home. Betty loved this.
Special price if you buy two.
She likes stealing stuff. It's kind of just, yeah.
We'll have to tame the one we want.
Okay. Better find a gift for Daniel quick. While he's still...
Hey. Hey, Sean. What's up?
Just... wanted to thank you for bringing us out here.
Hey, no problem. I hope you'll find what you're looking for. It's kind of a tiny place.
It's perfect. Don't worry. Good luck with that tree.
Yeah, I sure need it. It's not an easy task with this guy. Come get me when you're done.
I will.
Hmm. I might have to steal the yo-yo. Because I don't really think I got anything else.
It's me, you've come to take my duality. Wakes the midnight time I could not see. If I were you, were you, were me, We played a game of skillful ends, and so I asked for your demands. Give me your love, give me your gun, and you traced us back to where we'd begun. So the morning came and swept the night away, and I was looking for a way to disappear amongst the quiet things and all these empty streets. I found a way, I found a way to reappear.
Wow, you made it all the way through. Weird. You got a crush on me or something?
What? No, I mean, it was pretty cool. I just...
Relax, dude. It's cool that you listened. People are usually too busy to care.
You have a great voice. You should be on one of those singing shows.
That's kind of nice. Not really my thing, though. I hate TV and show business shit.
Well, thanks for the music. And good luck.
See ya.
Now I want to look up that song, because it sounds really, really good.
I miss Dad's Christmas at all. I think Daniel has enough broken toys.
Ooh, sit and draw. Been a while since I've done this. I have a feeling that, you know, I miss them, but it's fine.
Okay, got it.
Hey, anyone got some spare change for a young, beautiful, homeless thing?
I've looked enough. Time to draw now.
And foreground.
This place is nice. Pretty good. But I can add more details if I want.
And now for the foreground.
What are you drawing? Whoa, it's so cool. Are you like a professional?
Nah, more like the opposite.
You could draw comic books, the awesome adventures of Captain Spirit and Super Wolf.
Pretty rad for a Hollywood name. Yeah. I'll think about it.
Hey, can you add something funny to your drawing?
Funny? Like what?
I don't know. Something cool.
Okay. Big question. Zombies or UFO?
Zombies.
What about a zombie attack on Beaver Creek?
No.
I hope I can draw like you one day.
I'm sure you will, man.
I think I'm gonna go steal the yo-yo. I kinda wanted to buy stuff, but I don't have money.
Quiet morning.
I know it sucks, but Daniel deserves it too, right? This is so different from Seattle. Don't know if I can get used to it.
Found what you were looking for, city boy?
Yeah. Something for my little brother.
You bought your brother something out here. Damn. Poor kid. Sorry. I'm just a grumpy old gal. Me and my friends have been crashing here for the week. Nobody gives a shit about us. Yeah, I can tell you're not from around here.
Now we are. Kinda.
That sounds complicated.
Yeah.
Trauma?
Yeah. Lots.
Huh. Yeah, I hear that. Way too much.
What about you and your friends? Road trip?
Not really. We kinda hop from place to place, hunting for little jobs.
Must be a long ride.
That's okay. We hop on trains. Gives us time to rest.
Man, that sounds wicked.
You have no idea. It's free and so fucking fun. Well, unless you get caught or fall, but we've been lucky so far. That's the best. Nobody tells us what to do. No corporation owns us.
And you get to see so many cool places.
Exactly. Next stop is Humboldt County, California.
Stoner break.
Not even close. We actually got work over there.
Sean, what are you doing? We hit the tree with Chris. It's all crooked like an old witch. Oh, hi. Who are you? Ooh. Your hair looks so cool. Is it a wig?
Well, what do you think?
I don't know, but it's really cool. I'm Daniel. What's your name?
Hi, Daniel. I'm Cassidy. I dig your superhero outfit.
I'm on a secret mission with my friend. It's very dangerous.
I can tell. I hope you get your mission accomplished. And what's your name?
Oh, Sean. I thought I told you.
Now you did.
Sorry, you went through some shit with the guys. How much you make? You ready? Hello, pups.
Ooh, is that your doggy? So cool.
Yeah, he's been through a lot. Like most of us. So we adopted him. And he stinks. Yeah, you stink and you like it, huh?
Well, he's not the only one.
Have you checked your hair? I think it just twitched. You should keep your distance, dude.
She looks really cool, I think.
See? He knows I'm clean. You're the nasty one.
Yeah. You always go for those suburban boys.
Are you kidding? You want to talk about your scoreboard, hotshot?
Hey, no worries.
Come on, let's bail.
It was nice meeting you, Sean and Daniel.
Stay out of trouble,
goodbye.
Kids.
Goodbye.
Hope we see you on the rails someday.
Yeah. See you around.
Your doggy was so cute. I miss Mushroom.
I miss her, too.
Hey, excuse me. Dogs have to be on a leash around here. Too many strays.
Sorry, dude. We don't do leashes.
Well, the city does. An unleashed dog is liable to a fine, so...
You're gonna fine our dog? Well, that's not very nice.
Loitering is illegal, too. And you don't live here, right? Right?
Calm down, sweetie. We're allowed to visit the Christmas market. Our dog's not gonna eat you. Look at him.
You better watch your mouth. You punks are always causing trouble. This is a nice town, okay?
Jeez. Someone needs to get laid.
Yes.
He's out of pills.
That's it. I'm calling the cops.
Oh, God. He's gonna call the cops on us, Finn.
Chill out. We're leaving this shithole anyway. You guys don't even have a Santa, for Christ's sake.
Merry Christmas!
Fucking parasites.
Why did they fight? I don't get why he yelled like that. Should we do something about it?
Nah.
Better not get involved, man. This guy doesn't look nice.
You're right.
And plus, you know.
They're pretty.
Yeah, it's out of bike. I don't really know.
Jeez. Daniel Snowman wasn't that creepy after all.
And you know.
Hey, you guys ready to go?
Yeah. All done.
Cool. Hop in. Are you having too much fun back there?
Yeah.
That's what I thought.
I don't really like riding like the back of trucks like that, you know? Feels like I'm just gonna fall out, especially if like, because a lot of times they don't have like any like safety measures back there other than just like, oh, the bed, you know? It's the bed of the truck they'll keep you in.
Looks like Daniel found a new brother.
No kidding. He dumped me like a rock.
I'm glad you two came along. It's great that Chris found a new friend out here. It looks like you did too. What's her name?
Cassidy? Cassidy.
Cute name. Do you like her?
She was cool.
You're too quick! Ah!
Anyway,
got ya!
It's good for me to get out, too. We've had a rough time over the past couple of years. My wife, Emily, she died 2 years ago. Obviously, it was tough on Chris.
Shit. I'm sorry, man.
Thanks. It's been a struggle. Especially trying to be a good dad.
Do you have some kind of problems?
I'm just not the man I was. I shouldn't have even brought this up, you know, just forget it.
No worries. Didn't mean to make you feel bad.
Hey. How long are you staying at your grandparents?
I don't know. Depends on how long Stephen and Claire will put up with us.
Well, they stopped by yesterday. They really seem to care about Chris. But I'm afraid they get the wrong idea sometimes. Claire threatens to call social services. That's true. We are not your usual, pretty happy, suburban family model. But I know things haven't always been good for the Reynolds either.
Yeah, my mom left my dad a long time ago. She never came back. She broke all ties with her parents, too.
Sorry for bringing that up.
It's okay. I hope they don't stress out because we haven't come back.
Yeah, we should get you two home. Don't keep them waiting.
Yeah.
Hey, buddy. Wanna set up that Christmas tree?
Yeah!
Well, I'll get there before you with my dadmobile.
No way you can beat Captain Spirit. See you later, Super Wolf.
Hello? Hello? Claire? Steven?
Looks like Grandma and Grandpa haven't come back from church yet.
Well, at least they won't yell at us for going out.
That was so cool to spend time with Chris at the market.
So, did you set things straight with him? Told him the truth?
Yeah, I did. He was disappointed.
Of course he was. You lied to him.
Did you know Chris's mom was an artist?
I didn't. How so?
She drew comics. You should see her drawings. They're so cool. Just like yours.
Thanks, dude.
Hey.
What? What is it?
Sean? I want to go check on the room. Upstairs. I know it's Mom's. Please.
Daniel, you heard Claire. They will freak out if they know we went inside.
We won't tell them. We'll be in total stealth mode. They won't know anything if we make it quick. It's just... I really want to know what's inside. What kind of stuff she had. Chris has tons of things that belong to his mom. And I have nothing. Come on, Sean. You don't even have to come with me. If you don't want to.
Fuck it. I'll come with you. So you don't make a mess and get us caught.
Should probably tell him to wash the Super Wolf stuff off his face because, you know.
The door's still locked.
We'll find a way to open it.
Sean, this is super easy. I can just break the lock with my power.
Yeah, I could do that with a hammer. But let's try and find the key instead, all right?
Yep, probably in here.
I'm just gonna clean up real quick.
That's fine.
Locked drawer. Maybe the key to Karen's room is inside. Who knew this sweet little muffin would turn into such a brat? Still super cute, though. Love the outfits, guys.
Dude.
Man.
I'll stay here in case they come back.
Yeah, no. No way I'm searching Claire's underwear.
So, yeah. Okay, and the drawing of Daniel. Spirit Squad.
Come on, little key. Don't be shy. Wonder what would have been different if Dad had taken us to church. How much more Irish can you be? Didn't know Claire had sleep troubles. Definitely not the one. Way too small. But let's see what it opens. Yes, Daniel, I know. Whoa, I'm just looking for a key, not the crown jewels. Ew, are these
baby teeth? Yeah.
Teeth? Not sure if it's gross or cute. But still, no key here.
Well, at least you tried.
Okay, Steven. Where do you hide this key? I don't really see Steven listening to old school pop rock music. We clearly don't share politics, but at least Steven doesn't preach. Yeah, not much to see in here. Shit. These are Christmas presents? Let's not tell Daniel, or he'd freak. clothes, old stuff. But definitely no hidden key.
I kind of hope that it's like not. I kind of hope what it is it's like a
sharp object. Bit like Claire.
That, like, you know, that they went looking out for us because they came home and find either of us in here, you know? Okay, and... okay, so...
yep, it's empty.
Well, worth a shot.
Okay, Daniel. Think hard. What was she wearing?
Jeez. I think it was that weird sweater thing.
Dude, you rock.
Weird sweater thing. Okay, I don't know.
I gotta find a way to open that door. Or Daniel's gonna keep ranting about
it. Okay, oops. Skip. Oh, old box. I did not notice that. Good thing I looked up. Because I probably can ask Daniel to break the lock, but I want to try and do it stealthily because...
Would be cool to ask Steven about his firefighting career. That would have been really useful when we lived in the woods. Karen's smile on this picture kind of reminds me of Daniel's. Small town hero starter pack. Shit. Wish I had the chance to find my thing, too.
So now I can...
come on! Where is...
nope, okay. I don't know what I need to find. Maybe in the bathroom?
This whole house is pretty much a huge washing machine.
Don't think so.
Daniel, you really think you could open this door without doing too much damage?
Yes, I know I can. Come on, Sean. If you can't find the key, I could still use my power.
I'm tempted to look up a... fuck it. I want to do it without breaking the lock. I'm going to look up where the key is. Okay. Okay, you know what? That's actually a fair point. I should have looked there. I should have looked again, especially... yeah. Because this is where the cardigan is.
Yes.
Okay.
I found one key, so it better fit.
Just try it.
At least we didn't break the lock, which, you know, would have caused way, way, way more suspicion.
Wow.
Everything's
boxed
up.
There's not that much left.
Yeah.
Where do you think they put the rest of her stuff?
Probably in the attic or something along those lines.
It's her teenage room. I'm sure she sorted through her things before leaving for Seattle. The rest is probably packed in these boxes. They want to forget anything related to Karen. I can relate. This playlist is boring as hell.
Yeah, probably because she took all the rests in there.
Hope you enjoyed your trips. So you didn't bail on us for nothing. I don't recognize any of these games. Read a lot of these in the 10th grade. Yawn. Well, figures Karen was already looking for an exit. Okay, Daniel.
You've seen everything you wanted to see? Claire and Steven will be home soon now.
Just...
Man. That pen pal sure loved listening to her own voice.
Okay, thank you so much for your letter. I thought you might have forgot your pen pals. If so, bueno, here you are. So, Lonnie, Beefcook, I so proud of Foucher. It's not funny that I have a big family, so it shows. You could get your whole self like a queen. I told you before how stupid my brother Keaton is. Such an immature boy. Even though he's the oldest of my siblings, he thinks he's so cool because he has a driver license. I just... my dad yelling, I gotta go bail before that. So please write back as soon as you can. Your favorite pen pal, Emma.
Just 5 more minutes.
Is that an amethyst? She was into new age bullshit.
Why would they remove...
Is that an amethyst? She was into new... Yeah. You finally left forever. Hmm. Because they made them sad.
Yeah. Dad did the same thing, too. I've never seen any picture of Mom in our home.
These pictures are so... random. Hmm. They looked happy. How could you send all of this to hell?
That's a good question.
I think I saw a moon eclipse once. Before Daniel was born. Karen liked to take pictures of strangers when we walked down the streets. I don't know. I don't think she...
Oh.
Never been a big fan of hiking. But here I was. I miss my skateboard. I'm going to the park. I know when I'm... With Lila.
Yeah, come on.
It's like she almost never used those. Mm. I think I remember that one. Karen showed it to me once. Ulysses. Hey, Daniel, check this out. His name is Ulysses.
Like... the hero?
I guess.
So cool.
Hmm.
Hi, Ulysses.
I don't think there's... I kind of explored everything, right? The only thing I didn't look at the CD player.
I miss my music.
I don't want to play it, because that seems like a stupid, stupid idea. Oh.
Why would Claire lock these up in here?
Is that for Mom? Huh? Let me see-
Daniel! Come on.
Well, what does it say?
What's it say? Read it!
Seriously, stop! Here, how about this?
I've heard the news about Seattle. Please help my boys if they come to you. What? Why did they hide this from us?
I don't know.
Probably
you can reach me at this address. It's a... P.O. box I use sometimes. What's a P.O. box?
Well, a cop-out, in this case.
I beg you, please help my sons.
Oh yeah, right. Total bullshit.
What do you mean? She cares about us.
Well, I don't.
Maybe she changed her mind. We could try and contact her.
You don't even know her, okay? Don't get any wrong ideas. We should just stick to our plan. For now.
Can I read it again?
Yeah. Then we gotta go.
My goodness.
Oh. Shit.
Excuse me. What are you both doing in here? Except visibly. Ransacking our house while we're at church?
We were just looking for answers, and,
Was it worth stealing my key?
Claire, please. calm down.
No, Stephen. They went way out of line here. We specifically told you to stay out of this room.
I just wanted to see my mom stop.
This isn't her room anymore. There is nothing to see in here. It's time you learn to respect some rules.
Actually, we did find something.
Yeah, we found a new letter from my mom. She said she wants to see us. But you didn't even tell us.
She's not my daughter anymore, or your mother. She burned all those bridges. One letter doesn't change what she did to me, all of us. She is not welcome back.
It's been 8 years. Maybe it's time to move on.
Don't you dare lecture me, Sean. You don't know anything about how I feel.
I can't hear that.
Listen, Sean. I know life has been tough on you the past month. Bless your souls. And we put up with a lot of things. But that, going through our stuff, our personal belongings, well, that shows you don't respect us. Then you act like I'm the bad guy, after what we've done for you. I knew something like this might happen. Maybe you two staying here wasn't such a good idea.
Man, I think I see why Mom left now. She couldn't put up with your stupid rules anymore.
Oh, so that's what you think. Then let me tell you something.
Huh?
Steven!
Shit.
Oh, shit! Get this goddamn thing off me!
Steven, no! Hold on, honey, we'll get it off!
No! Stop! Oh, my legs!
Fuck it.
Do it, Daniel! Now!
Do what? What's going on? Oh, Lord, what? What are you doing, Daniel? Oh, my baby, Stephen, are you okay?
Now I am. Thanks to Daniel. You were right, Claire. I should have fixed that cupboard months ago. I guess my laziness will get me someday.
What in the name of God was that all about? That's impossible. What are you, Daniel?
Claire. Listen,
they saved me, Claire. That's all that matters.
Maybe. It was a miracle. Oh, thank you, Lord. It's the sheriff.
Stephen? Claire?
Sean, I didn't. We didn't call them.
I know, Grandma.
Shit. Fuck. I didn't. I should have just stuck to the blog. I didn't think this shit would happen. Ah, fuck. Shit, I fucked up.
What are we gonna do?
Go hide in the garage.
No. No. No way. If the police searches the house, that makes the two of you accomplices.
Get your bags and go out the back door. I'll distract him.
Really?
Yes. Now, get the hell out of here.
So sorry for everything. I wish we could have helped you more. I wish you could stay here with us. Watch out for your brother, Sean.
Yes. Be careful. We'll see you as soon as we can, okay?
Thanks for helping us. Both of you.
Oh, we love you. Now hurry up.
Dana, wait for me while I go upstairs.
You better come back. Hold on a second. Here, this is your cape. You're the real superhero.
Thanks, Triss. That's super cool. Like you.
Daniel, let's go.
Take the Troll Forest shortcut. It's right through there. Nobody will find you.
Chris. You rock.
Goodbye, Captain Spirit.
See you around, Super Wolf. The Spirit Squad will stay united forever.
Whoa!
I'm assuming this is the end of the episode, because it seems like a decent ending. I want to know if, no matter what happens, will the cops come? God, this game is making me want to replay it all, so I see all the different choices and everything. Because now that I know what the key is, it's clearly that I can go in there much faster and do things easier, so I could possibly get in and out.
I feel like a fake superhero. Chris was so sad when he found out that...
He had to find out anyway. Before he did something... dangerous.
I know. I just feel sorry for him.
Don't be. No matter what happened, I think you guys will always be friends.
I hope. Sean... I'm tired of running away. I don't want to be a superhero anymore.
You don't have to use your power if you don't want to.
I know, but sometimes I can help, and how do I know when to use it?
You don't. You can only trust your guts, and... listen to your brother.
You think we'll see Grandma and Grandpa again?
I don't know. We'll see.
Where are we gonna go now? See Mom?
No way, man. We don't need her, okay?
But...
said she wanted to find us.
We stick to the plan. We go to Puerto Lobos. That's where we belong. No one will tell us what to do. We can be whoever we want.
You think? I don't know.
Trust me, man. From now on, we make our own rules. Look, I even got you a present. Merry Christmas, Enano.
For real? But it's in 2 weeks.
Who cares? Dates are boring. Here.
Gee. A yo-yo? Awesome. Early Christmas is the best. Hey, I got something for you two. I wanted to finish it, but we're doing it now, so.
Oh, man. That's so cool.
Hey, listen.
There's our ride. Come on, all aboard.
It's kind of nice not having consistent characters besides Daniel and Sean, but it's also, I kind of am missing that consistency, you know? But it is a nice dynamic of how we're constantly moving around and thus meeting new people. And right, licensed music is supposed to be playing right now, because that's what I'm assuming, because everything sort of has begun to quiet down. I also have a feeling we jumped on the same train as Cassidy. Because, you know, that would be perfect, since we just met her, and then we met her halfway through the episode and did not get time to, you know, fully explore things, but... To that be continued. Episode 2, rules. I'll let, there's supposed to be music playing, I assume, here as well. But, I have a feeling that a lot of these people are going to change, but I do think that by the end of episode 5 that there'll be the similar credits, so I'm kind of just fast-forwarding through this. I want to also double-check the music, because that was licensed track, Death with Dignity, Mr. Wolf, Red vs. I Found a Way. And Square Enix stuff. I'm gonna actually look up that song that played halfway through the episode, because that was a really good song. Yeah, this was episode 2. I liked it a bit more because it clearly showed that choices were beginning to matter a bit more. Because episode 1, sort of, your choices didn't really affect things. Because I feel like, you know, like, Mushroom and that character growth didn't really matter as much as inside episode 2, and I hope episode 3 continues on that trend where the choices either begin to cascade or the choices affect episodes way later down the line, you know? Because that's sort of like the thing about like Telltale stuff, is that a lot of the Telltale stuff sort of just, it fell short because your choices at the end of the day didn't matter as much. Like, it didn't matter who you talked to, who you saved, or things like that. It just it still ultimately just had the same, it still ultimately got the same thing, you know? And so, I've been really liking that. Free spirits. You threw a snowball properly, you threw a small ball at Daniel, at Mushroom, at Daniel and Mushroom. You interfered and scared the cougar off. You prayed together with Claire and Daniel, refused to pray. Claire played her own, no one played. You confessed to Steven about Daniel's powers, pretending you didn't know anything. You helped affect your chores. You told Daniel he did the right thing when you saved Chris. You used Steven's laptop to log into your profile. That's the biggest choice, and I feel like that fucked up. And I didn't... You couldn't talk to Lion and lie to you, to her mother, and told the truth to her mother. I feel like the profile and the call would have led to the police coming here. I want to know what happened if you didn't do that. And you didn't gain Chris's trust, yeah. You told Daniel to stop lying to Chris. I was just a minority there. Cassie sung to the end, cool. You didn't draw for Chris. You drew space zombies for Chris. You saw Christmas presents for Daniel. You didn't get involved in Charlie's problem. I feel like I should have, especially since I left. You let Daniel use his power, and the cops chased you, and fucking what? The cops chased you, and Chris was hit by a car? Oh, God. Oh, dear Lord. I have a feeling that's because we... Yeah, because we managed to gain their trust at the end there, and so they helped us escape, meaning the cops didn't chase us. The cops chased you, and Chris wasn't hit by a car. Oh, boy. Daniel continued to swear. Daniel did not continue to swear. Daniel won the gay sign, won the nice game without cheating. Daniel didn't kill the cougar. Daniel was not able to bury Mushroom. Daniel agreed to play. Daniel tidied the room. Daniel obeyed and told Chris the truth about his powers. Daniel was told to tell the truth, but he continued to lie to Chris. Ooh, that would have been bad. Overall, Daniel was repressed from using his powers. Didn't really mean to do that. Daniel didn't have to save Chris. Daniel used his power to save Chris from the car. Daniel didn't have to save his power. Didn't use his powers. Daniel didn't blame anyone since Chris was fine. Blamed you for Chris's accident. Daniel enjoyed his early Christmas presents. Okay. Seems like there was a lot going on here. And I'm going to assume that when I press continue... Yeah, it moves straight on to episode 3. So, yeah. Hope you all enjoyed this episode.
So
and seasons.
This is it?
It's playing music and stuff, even though I paused. But I hope you all enjoyed that, so I will see you. But anyway, I'll see you all next time. You know, still got 3 more episodes to go through. Until next time.